Welcome to the tutorial of Unreal 2 Particle Salamanders. Particle Salamanders are a type of particle generators used in Unreal 2 The Awakening and Unreal 2 Expanded Multiplayer that unfortunately have a very small amount of documentation. Yet the particle engine is very intuitive and very powerful, allowing level designers to create good-looking particles quickly and easily. So let's start the tutorial. First of all, find a good place to place your particles. I will choose an outdoors area, like here. This is my own map, which is a port of XMP Alcazar from Expanded Multiplayer, but it is actually in Unreal 2 The Awakening. You may also create a cube of death, that is a simple cube, and place it in an empty map. Now, make sure that you have real-time preview turned off. Then right-click and add a particle salamander by using the command add particle salamander here. Now, open its properties and turn back real-time preview. You'll notice that the icon has disappeared. That means that it tries to show particles, but there are no particles to show. That's why you have to have real-time preview turned off before placing the particle salamander. Now, the first thing you want to go to is particle salamander here, and make sure to have two things changed. Now, first is volume. Volume is a number of particles that you can see on your screen at one time. So I will input 20 here. Now you will see min volume, that is the minimum particles that you can see on the screen at the same time. This is for those who have settings different in Unreal 2 The Awakening, where you can select particle density. So the less particle density there is, the less particles you will see, and depending on min volume, that's the minimum they will see. Naturally, if you turn 0, they will not see anything. So make sure it is something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or something like that. Now the spread is basically the corner where all the particles will be sprayed at. I will select 360, so it will emit it to all the sides from the particle salamander. Now you will not see anything just yet. That's because we need to add some particle templates, which are under particle generator. Now, of course, make sure that on is true, otherwise it will not show anything. Now, the tricky part here is that you actually, as you can see, there is no add button or anything like that. Instead, you have a drop-down list. Once you select anything from the drop-down list, it automatically adds it to the particle templates. Now, you can see that there are a lot of different things to choose from. Well, all of these are explained in one of the posts that the original creators of Unreal 2 The Awakening have posted on forums, and I will probably add links to that in my description of this video. Now, let's see. The usual thing that you want to select is rotating particle template. That means that these particles will rotate depending on the settings you choose, and they will always look at your screen. Now, another thing that you may want to choose is particle decal template. These templates make it so that all the particles don't look at your screen directly, but they're viewed much like a static mesh that is looking only to one part of the world instead of your screen. And you may choose streak particle template. Now, if you click on the zero sign here, you will get another drop-down list. This is a list of forces. We will get to that later. Let us add a textured streak particle template, which is right here. Now, we can select a texture from the textured streak particle template. As you can see, it is already selected for us, but we still cannot see anything. So, first of all, we may want to select a different texture for our streaks, and Unreal 2 The Awakening has a very nice list of all the different textures you can choose, and it is in particle systems. As you can see, the list is just huge. Since we want streaks, we will select streaks, and yeah, there aren't too many options, so let's just select streak 01. Or yeah, it's already selected, so that's okay with me. And then we can select all of these different properties. You're free to actually try them out. This program doesn't really crash so often. If you do something really stupid, then it will crash, but usually it just turns off the entire particle template and resumes operation once you actually change all the invalid options that you have chosen. Now, let's see. You can change the colors, but I do not think that you need to do so. Now, in particle template, you will want to change the initial speed and initial lifespan of this. Let's say the speed is 100. And yes, as you can see, we have already got ourselves a very nice an emitter, which gives us some nice streaks, which look a lot like sparks. So, as you can see, these streaks are white. They're white because we didn't choose any color in here. So let's choose a color. This time, you will see a button add, and you can add a color. As you can see, this made everything disappear because it's black. You will actually want to use this 3 points, and it lets you select it. I want a nice blue particle like this, and yeah, as you can see, now it gives us this very nice effect that is very similar to what we saw on the Drakk Homeworld. And yes, now you can change the length. As you can see, A and B, these mean that it's a sort of maximum and minimum, but it doesn't really matter where is maximum and where is minimum. That makes this particle engine very convenient. So if we change it to 5, we will have a lot of small particles. Okay, just turn that back to 10. Okay, and as you can see, we already have very nice particles, but we can have better. As you can see, they just disappear. So what can we do so it fades out nicely? Well, first of all, I want to change the initial lifespan to something longer, such as 3. Now you can see that it goes all the way around the world. Now, also, one thing that you should note is extents. You cannot open it. But what is very important is that if you see any kind of extents, like x is not 0, y is not 0, and such, and at the end of this, it says is valid equals 1, that means that it is valid, of the particle template is valid, and it should show something. If it's not valid, then it won't show anything, and you will know that you have made some kind of a mistake in creating it.